All right, Sunday, back home from the big trip. I'm kind of whipped, but the wife's got to make another trip in the little Honda car tomorrow, so I got to move this out of the way. Looks like I better put a battery in it and Firebird out of the way so I can get the Honda in and do some work on it. There she goes again. My goodness. All right, we moved two vehicles and put this one inside. And now I understand that's the VTEC solenoid right there. We're gonna disassemble that and see what we see. And we gotta put a rear wheel bearing on it. We gotta move a few other things so we can get at the rear wheel bearing. Hopefully that won't be too bad. I don't wanna work on a Honda all day. All right, got the brake caliper and the caliper mounting bracket and the rotor off. And here's the bearing. It's not very noisy that way, but boy, when you're going 70 miles an hour, it howls. So I think I just need to take that nut there off, and then that bearing should pop right off, and then reinstall the new one. This is the old bearing. This side turns beautifully, and it says USA on it. Japanese car with a USA bearing. But this is the inside, and it'll barely turn. Evidently, that seal got bad and got some water in there or something. So I'm gonna toss this to the side and put this new made in China bearing on there. Awesome, huh? All right, got the nut on there. Torqued it to 134 foot-pounds. My torque wrench. And now I can put the rest of it back together and see how it goes. Spins nice and quiet. We'll see how long the Chinese thing lasts. Alright, got that all reassembled. Thing's gonna need some new brake pads here shortly. But I don't have them, so we're gonna let it run a little bit. Probably need to put some new rotors on it too. But it's got to go down the road tomorrow. So we'll put it all back together, put the wheel on, and see about this VTEC thing. Well, I removed that VTEC solenoid right quick, but before I get too involved in that, I better get some new gaskets. Those are O-ring type. If I tear one of them, disassembling any further will be in trouble, so I think I'll do that. Bolt this thing back together and hopefully it'll make it to Georgia tomorrow. Alright, it's all put back together. I need to do a little more research, see how to test that solenoid and its oil pressure switch there. And I noticed that one plug's missing a clip. It might have just backed out a little bit. I think it got broke. The transmission's been out of this thing 3 times. So one of those times, probably the clip got broke on that oil pressure sensor there, sender. It activates the VTEC. It might have just been a little loose, I don't know. But anyway, it didn't act up all the time, just sometimes. So we'll see what happens. That's all it's getting out of me tonight.